Welcome to the Tactical Flag Command Center, or TFCC. This is where the Admiral would manage the entire carrier strike group or task force, as the case may be. And TFCC provides three functions for the Admiral and his staff, the primary of which is a clear understanding of where all of the friendly, unknown, and enemy forces are operating, where they're located, and what they're doing, or their intentions. And this information comes into the center and provides the staff with something that we refer to as situational awareness, or SA. Good SA is absolutely critical to decision making in the Admiral's staff and in the Admiral himself, and provides the environment from which good, clear decisions can be made. Once that occurs, the third function may happen, and that is the precise and accurate execution of command and control over the entire task force. In order to make all of this occur, the environment was supported by a series of systems of communications, which were either shipboard or it would be satellite communications. And then that communications comes in and forms kind of a communications command and control and intelligence hub, or C3I hub. And that hub provides data that will feed a number of the important systems that are used by the Admiral staff, the primary of which is the Navy Tactical Data System, or NTDS. Tactical Flag Command Center takes that same system, zooms out, gets a much bigger 60,000 foot view, which is much more strategic in nature, because the Admiral has to look at not just the Midway, but has to look at all the other ships in the battle group or the task force. Now there are other information coming in provides the other side of the picture, because NTDS provides where the friendly forces are and where the unknown forces are. It doesn't tell us anything about where the threat is. Now, providing that information and coming into this space are the secure encrypted communications that are supporting the supplementary plot or subplot. The hub for all of the information that I've just talked about is coming into a space to the location here right behind me, which is called a T table because it's shaped like a big T. And sitting at that table is the primary watchstander for the Admiral, called the Battle Watch Captain, the focal point for all of the information that's coming in that I've just described. Much of it coming in through NTDS, the Navy Tactical Data System. Some of it is coming in from Intel, and some of it is coming in from another system over here, which is referred to as the Joint Operational Tactical System, a steady stream of information that's encrypted and formatted to be machine readable so that they can take that data and display it on the screen and provide information on where threat contacts or other enemy locations are and what they're doing. If you'll see on the T table are two red phones, secure level encrypted voice communications that can go out and either talk to an individual ship or the entire task force. So as you can see, this space, while it doesn't have a lot of systems, it's a small space, it has a huge mission, and the Admiral is facilitated mostly by the communications that are fed in here. And all of those communications, in many cases, they're all secret level, secure, and encrypted. And what does that mean? That means that at least once a day, every 24 hours, they would change out the crypto on those units, making them secure. And what am I talking about crypto? The cryptographic information is the key code that goes in and absolutely feeds every one of these and changes the data on a daily basis, so that the other side, the adversary, if they're trying to read our mail, so to speak, they can't do it because the crypto is changed out so frequently. Okay, now that you know how important this space is, it would be wonderful if you could come by and visit with us when you're next here on the Midway.